of our first group actually is from Denver. I don't know why I look at it, it's not even that complicated. He's a writer and he's kind of an outdoorsy type. Please welcome Steve O'Neill.
My name's Steve O'Neill, and I'm not gay. Jesus. Okay, I really needed to get that out. It's weird, I have this little bit of paranoia that people think I'm gay. Not that there's anything wrong with that. But it's really affecting my life. It's really affecting my life. I'm very cautious about what I order at restaurants. Careful about the clothes I wear. I get really self-conscious when I'm having sex with men. I don't want to feel guilty ordering a salad and a Diet Coke off of Chili's guiltless grill. I always feel the need to, before I say anything remotely homosexual about another man, that I have to preface it with, I'm not gay or anything. You know, women don't have to do that. They don't. Holy shit. Rebecca. That top makes your tits look huge. Jealous. You never hear them prefacing it with, not lesbian or anything. So if I want to say to my buddy, dude, sweet shorts, bro. That totally would make your dick look gigantic. Doing when it comes to sex either, because we're rarely honest with each other about it, you know? It's like, did you like it?
That's nice.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start handing out a post-coital survey. It's a classy way to say sex. Post-coital survey. You'd be like, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much did you enjoy yourself? 10 being mind-blowing, 1 being repulsive. Did you reach orgasm? If not, why? I mean, we live in a society. We live in a society that embraces speed. I mean, we drive fast, we eat fast food, we want the fastest 4G network, but God forbid if I come within the first 30 seconds. I want to celebrate it. Here, fill out the survey. She got a tough time about this on stage because I want women to find me attractive. cute. But he might be a premature ejaculator. There's paperwork. Plus my mom's here. It's interesting. Humans are the only species on this planet that deal with insecurity on a massive scale, like every single day. Animals don't do that. Think about a whale, for instance. I mean, I'm no marine biologist, by any means, but I don't think those whale songs that we hear are them bitching about their feelings. I can't believe I'm still living in my mother's pod. This chair's wild. I'm 50% blubber. This plankton diet is bullshit. Reflection, but we hate to admit it. I was walking down the street the other day, and I caught a glimpse of myself in a shop window. So I walked over to it. I started adjusting my hair, and then I realized they can see me inside. So I pretend as if I'm looking through the window. It's a nail salon. I look like I'm admiring the interior of a nail salon. And then I think, shit, they probably think I'm gay. Thank you guys so much.